Good evening everyone. So this is the second part of the video. In first part I have already discussed how to calculate initial solution by using Weigel's approximation. So if you could remember, this is the table which I have got. And if I calculate the transportation cost, which I am writing as TPT cost. So I hope you all of you know how to calculate cost. It is 2 times 15 plus 9 times 15 plus 20 times 10 plus 18 times 5 plus 4 times 5, which in all is coming out to be, if I convert it into rupees, it is rupees 475. So please cross check if it is coming a little here and there. It doesn't matter, but it is that's how the transportation cost is to be calculated. Now I'll be discussing further then what exactly is the degeneracy. So I've already told you that this is a degenerate transportation problem because number of allocations are less than equal to rho plus m minus 1. So rho plus column minus 1. So I'll be telling you where actually degeneracy creates a problem. If the problem is degenerate, and if I start calculating, start using optimality test on this particular problem, then there comes a problem. So how does it appears? So in order to calculate optimality test, what I do is, first I'm calculating u value. So I'll be calculating u1, u2, u3 here. And then I'll be calculating v1, v2, v3 and v4. Here. Okay, so first I'll take the u2 value equal to 0 with maximum number of allocations. So I have two rows here, row 2 and row 3, which have both of them have equal number of allocations. So I can choose any of them. So let's say I'm taking u2 is equal to 0. So u2 is equal to 0, which I have already marked. Now what I should do is, what I should do in order to calculate rest of the values. For non-empty cells, the formula is, if I'm writing here, it is ui plus vj is equal to cij. So for, let us suppose for this particular corresponding cell, u value, ui is this u value, vj is this corresponding column value, is equal to cij is the cost which is mentioned right here, 20. So first I have to apply operation on all non-empty cell. This formula stands for all non-empty cells. Non-empty cells mean where the allocation exists. That means 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. I can apply this particular formula in these 5 cells. So right now I'm applying this formula in this particular cell. So it will become U2 plus V4 is equal to 20. So by doing that, if I know it is already 20 and U2 is equal to 0, so V4 will turn out to be 20. Now again, if I calculate same way for this particular cell right here, it will be U2 plus V3 is equal to 9. So U2 is already 0, so V3 will come out to be 9. Now I want to calculate all U's and V's. So by using this particular allocated cell, I can calculate this U3 value. It will be U3 plus V4 is equal to 18. And when I'll be doing the calculation, it will come out to be minus 2. Now again, what I supposed to do is, I can use this u value and this corresponding v value and this particular non-empty cell, and I can calculate the value of v1, which in this particular case will come out to be 6. V1 comes out to be 6. Now this is where the degeneracy creates a problem. If you see, now I don't have any allocated cell combination, both are empty. So I cannot calculate v2, I cannot calculate U1, and this problem is appearing because my number of allocations were less than rho plus column minus 1. So what I supposed to do in this particular case, I must allocate minimum value, which is also known as nearly equal to value, which I am putting here as delta. Now how this delta should be put? It should be put as per convenience. Though the first proposition is you should always put it in the cell which has the minimum cost. So here 7 is minimum cost, I'm putting delta here in the left out cells. Otherwise you can put delta at such a convenience so that you can calculate your u and v values. So now I can do that. Look, I can use this particular cell to calculate u2 and v2, and by using that I can calculate value of v2, which will come out to be 7 in this particular case. And after that I can calculate the value of U1, which will come out to be minus 5 in this particular case by using the same argument, that is U plus V minus 1. Now these right corners of the cells will be corresponding U plus V values. That means this particular cell will contain 6 plus minus 5, which will give me 1, then this particular value would be 9 minus 5, which would give me 4. This particular would be 20 minus 5, which is going to give me 15. This particular cell would be 9 minus 10, which is going to 9 plus 10, which is going to, okay, sorry. No, no, 9 plus minus 2, which is going to give me 7. Then 7 minus 2, which is going to give me 5. And here it is going to give me 6 minus 0, that is going to give me 6. So 10 minus 1, these values I am calculating, this that will decide the whether the solution is optimum or not. 10 minus 1 is 9. Then 20 minus 4 is 16. 11 minus 15 is minus 4. Then 14 minus 5 is 9. 16 minus 7 is 9. And 12 minus 6 is 6. So if all these values, which generally are called as DIJs, all these values are greater than or equal to 0, then the solution is optimum. That means this transportation cost is minimum. And if any of these value is less than 0, then in that case the solution is not optimum. So here I am getting this particular minus 4. That means this solution is not optimum. That means there is another solution which exists, which we need to find out. So in order to find out that new particular solution, we will use modified distribution method. So that I'll cover in my next video. So in this video, I discussed what kind of problems can appear because of degeneracy. Because of degeneracy, I cannot complete my optimum solution and how to remove degeneracy. So in next video, I'll be covering that how to reallocate and how to find another solution which is going to be giving me the optimum value.